In my family, they were always drilling in my head like, the way is, go to school, get an education, find a husband, get married, have kids. Deep inside, I always knew I was different. I had no interest in men. I was always interested in girls, but that was forbidden.
Toni is from the Caribbean. Discrimination and violence against the LGBT community here is very common. In her early 20s, Toni survived a violent attack by people who suspected she was gay, even though she had tried to hide it. Then she fell in love. The woman who was from England promised her a very different life.
So she persuaded me and persuaded me into coming to England. She put it in my brain that I could have a beautiful life in this England. That was all I was thinking about. This life to be gay and happy and proud and just be me.
Toni left her job, sold her house and car, and was going to leave the country without telling her family. But her girlfriend had other ideas.
She told me, no, you know what? Throw it in them face like, yeah, you're coming to a better life. Come out to everybody. And that's exactly what I did. And that was one of the most horrible days of my life.
The family were hostile and disowned her.
I knew there was no way back, so I had to condition my life now. This is my way forward. I made the decision, so I got to stick with it.
She'd burnt her bridges, but she was excited about starting a new life.
In the beginning, it was really good. It was really good. But about the second week, she told me she got to take my passport, my ID card, all my important documents from my country.
After that, things changed. The woman became controlling and threatening and made Toni do all the domestic work in the house. She was also spending the money Toni had brought from home. Toni was scared, but didn't know where she would go to get help.
She let me know that this is a white man country. If I ever see a black man police officer, I said no. And she was like, exactly. Because this is a white man country, and if you go to the police, who you think they're going to believe? Her, a white person, or me, the black person?
When the money was all spent, Toni was kicked out. She was homeless for the next 2 years. She often slept in a park, and a woman who lived nearby would bring her food. They would chat, and for the first time in a long time, Toni felt this was someone she could trust.
She looked me in the eye and said, I am going to help you. I'm going to help you. And I broke down. I broke right down.
With the woman's help, Toni got in touch with the Salvation Army.
The Salvation Army helped me in every single way. The support workers that were assigned to me from the Salvation Army, they went above and beyond to make sure that I was okay. They gave me emergency accommodation, and now I have my own home.
The Salvation Army also funded training, so she could apply for the kind of work she was doing in the Caribbean.
I now have leave to remain for 5 years. As I got my job now, I got my house, and just get involved in some LGBT organizations, and just try to live my normal life. I would like to say thank you to all the organizations that went out their way to help me. And most of all, the Salvation Army.